You're now riding with Miller, okay? Officer Jamko, Officer Witten, I need you to respond to the ME's office. Got a frequent flyer threatening to burn the place down.
NADP?
Well, they misplaced her father's body.
So what's the complaint?
She's threatening the employees, threw a boot at one of them when they told her to come back later.
Oh, gee, thanks. That sounds like a joy.
I'll get the car.
I'll get some fresh batteries.
Hey, did you hear that your dad has a hearing coming up? His lawyers filed a request for compassionate release.
Compassionate release based on what?
He's over 65, served more than half his sentence, has diabetes.
Hey, wait a second. Why do you know any of that?
He called last night, said that he would love it if you would come to the hearing.
He called you?
Yeah, said that he thought he had a better shot going through me, that you probably wouldn't want to talk to him.
He's right, I don't want to talk to him, and I do not want to go to his hearing.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding? I'm not filling out anything!
I told you!
You're trying to get rid of me, and you can go to hell, because I ain't moving!
What seems to be the problem?
They lost my dad's body!
We didn't lose
it! And I will not be pushed around!
I told her she needs to come back, but she's refusing to leave, and she's upsetting the other people that are coming here to identify their loved
ones. Well, lucky for them, they didn't lose their loved ones! They have them identified already!
You can't stay here. You have to leave.
Make me, pig!
That can be arranged.
Hey! Oh, you're very upset.
The nursing home where he lives said he was sent to St. Benjamin's, and St. Benjamin said he died and they sent him here. And this bitch here is telling me she doesn't know where he is.
First of all, you gotta calm down. And then you gotta watch your language.
What you gonna do, arrest me? Pepper spray me? I'm recording you right now.
This is the third time we've been called.
Because nobody is listening.
You've had two warnings already, so either you leave right now or you're under arrest for disorderly conduct.
Screw you.
Go on down, let's go. Turn around, hand finds your back. Other hand.
Hey, Witten, hang on.
What's your name?
Anita.
All right. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna find out what happened to your dad's body. But you have got to leave here right now.
I'll leave. But you've got one day before I'm back here.
No.
Eddie, hey, where's your arrest?
But she agreed to leave.
Wait. You agreed to help locate the body, didn't you? We are not social workers, Eddie.
Well, sometimes it's the same thing.
The ME's office said she threatened to burn down the building. What if she makes good on that and you could have prevented it?
I will prevent it by helping her.
Hold on. Call this number. She's a criminalist in the ME's office. She always helps me out.
She cute?
She's 60.
Oh, I'm gonna be 60 someday.
And I'll still have my hearts for you.
Hey, are you okay? You seem a little distracted.
Aaron called. Danny and Baez haven't responded to their radios or their phones since this morning.
Well, hey, I'm sure they just got wrapped up in a case.
Yeah, I'm sure you're right. I'll call you as soon as I hear. Go find your dead body.
Okay, thanks.
Hey, Lou. I'm about to take that lost time. Terry located Danny's vehicle. Unfortunately, they left the radio in the car.
Maybe they hopped out to interview a witness or to follow up on a lead. Who knows?
All right, hey, listen, we're doing a door-to-door search, okay? Two blocks in every direction, logged every address we hit. Let's go.
Jamie!
Hey.
Hey.
What are you doing here?
Hopefully getting a chance to help look.
Yeah, we can have one more. That'd be great. Anthony. This is Joe Hill. He's my,
family friend. I'm not looking to be on the clock, just want to help out.
Anthony Abramarco, I work with Evan. She told me about you. I'm a, family friend, too.
Sit.